Good morning, dear students. As in the previous video, we have discussed about meaning of economics, and then we have discussed about micro and macroeconomics. Today, we will discuss the difference or interdependence of micro and macroeconomics. First of all, let's discuss the difference between micro and macroeconomics. As this chapter is very important for you all, so I request you all to study this chapter properly and prepare notes, and if you find any doubt and any query, you can ask. I will be there, our school will be there to help you out in all your needs. So let's start. First of all, first basis is definition. As we have already discussed, that microeconomics is that part of economic theory which studies the behavior of individual units of an economy. In macroeconomics, we study about individual units of economy. Let's come to macroeconomics. Macroeconomics is that part of economic theory which studies the behavior of aggregate of the economy as a whole. Suppose in microeconomy, we are discussing about one person. And in macroeconomics, we will be discussing about many persons together. So it will be called macroeconomics. Okay. Next. Tools of analysis. In microeconomy, we study about demand and supply. And in macroeconomics, we study about aggregate demand and aggregate supply. Demand and supply by an individual will be treated in microeconomics. And demand and supply will, in the market, means aggregate demand and aggregate supply will be treated in macroeconomics. Then main objective. It aims to determine the price of the commodity or factors of production. Okay. And in macroeconomics, it aims to determine income and employment level of the economy. Okay. Next, basic assumption. It assumes all the macro variables, all the constant. It assumes that national income, consumption, savings are constant. In macroeconomics, all the external factors will be treated as constant, means there will be no change in all of them. But in macroeconomics, it deals with reality. It assumes that all the micro variables like decisions, household, of firm are constant. Means in microeconomics, all the elements of macroeconomics will be treated as constant. Vice versa, in macroeconomics, all the elements of microeconomics will be treated as constant. Okay. Then at last, other name. It's also known as price theory. Means microeconomics is also known as price theory. And it is also known as income and employment theory. Macroeconomics is treated as income and employment theory. So this is it. In this difference, let's move further. There is one more difference. Examples. In microeconomy, individual demand, firms' output, and in macroeconomics, as I will discuss the whole, national income and national output. Okay. So, moving further. It is difficult to decrimate or differentiate between macro and macroeconomics. What is macro from an economic point is micro in the concept of the word. Suppose we are discussing only about India. And we are discussing all the states of India. So it will become in microeconomics. But macroeconomics, but when we come to the whole, means when we treat as a word, that particular parties will be called as microeconomics. Okay. So according to Professor Samuelson, knowledge of both is absolutely vital, and there is no competition between micro and macroeconomics. Both are complementary and should be fully utilized for proper understanding of an economy. So if you want to learn economics properly, you have to learn microeconomics as well as macroeconomics completely. Okay. So now just move further. Positive or normative science. Economics is a positive science or economics is a normative science. It's also a very important topic. So positive economics deals with what is or how an economic problem facing a society is actually solved. How can we actually solve it? Professor Robbins held that economics was purely a positive science. According to him, economics should be neutral or silent between end. It should be no desire to learn about ethics of economic decision. He said that there is no desire to learn about the ethics. Okay. So what were their facts? India is an overpopulated country. Positive economic means. Then a fall of the price of the goods leads to the rise in quantity demand. By simple thi baat hai, it's quite simple. If the price of any commodity will decrease, the demand of that particular quantity will increase. Suppose a chocolate which costs rupees 50, now its cost is 30 rupees, so its demand will automatically increase. Price has been rising in India. Minimum wage increase unemployment. Okay. A perfect maximum firm, maximizing firm, will set its price where marginal revenue is equal to the marginal cost. Quite simple is that ki a firm will, suppose there is a firm, it will discuss their price according to their supply and revenue and cost. Air is the mixture of gases. Increase in real per capita income increase the standard of living of people. Suppose you are earning 10,000 per month and now your income is 50,000 per month. Your standard of living will automatically increase. Okay. So this is it for this video. We will discuss the normative science in the next video and this chapter will be completed. Till then, if you find any doubt and any query, you can ask. We will be there to help you out in all your needs. Good luck, students. Keep learning, keep studying, and keep yourself up to date. Till then, bye-bye, students.